Hey my glamkins, welcome back to my channel. So guys, in today's video I'll be reviewing Insight Cosmetics ultra thin second skin long wear foundation, and I have picked it up in the shade 01 golden honey. And this is how the foundation looks like. I've seen so many people loving this, so I thought of trying myself out. It comes in four different shades, and obviously I picked it up online. I thought that 01 golden honey will suit my skin tone as it says long wear, so I'll try and test it out, I think 7-8 hours, and see that how it performs throughout the day, and also how other products applies on top of this foundation. Because mostly what happens if the foundation is not of good quality, it slip and slides all the products which I applied on top of it. This is just for ₹160. I wish they have got more shades. They have only got 4 shades to choose from. It has got the shelf life of 36 months. It is cruelty free. It is manufactured in India, Palghar. Once you cracked open this, you have to use it in 3 years. Comes in this glass bottle and it has a dropper applicator. Let's read out the description. It is long wear and ultra light liquid foundation. It has got SPF 15, and it is also full coverage, you guys. Silky smooth formula. It's absolutely lightweight on the skin. Its buildable formula delivers a sheer to medium coverage. It is mattifying foundation which controls oil for a shine free finish. So it's a matte foundation. Pump a dollop onto your palm. With the applicator, apply a small dots all over your face and neck using your fingertips or a foundation brush, and blend the product well into the skin. By the way guys, I have received so many comments, people asking me to shoot my videos in natural light, and I am literally sitting in front of my window. So this is what my skin tone actually looks like without any artificial lights or anything. I've already used my moisturizer. For my primer, I'm taking Too Faced Hangover X. You can use any according to your choice. It's this much I am taking. I think I should remove my earrings before I start to apply foundation because I don't like that feeling. I will be applying my foundation with my beauty blender because I usually use my beauty blender to apply all of my liquid products onto my face. Rarely I use brushes for foundation and concealer. I think this shade is very, very light for my skin tone. Please let me know guys, if you are NC42 in MAC, what shade you use if you have tried this, because this might look ghosty. Also, it has got this weird smell, something like aftershave, I don't know, but it smells a little weird. It's not bad, but I don't like it. Applies nicely. It's not too matte how I thought it would be. Also, it is not too thick and it's not too watery. This shade is definitely very light for my liking because I like my foundation a little dark. Want little bit more of orange or yellow undertone to it. I'm going with one more coat and I'm using it second time. You can see those marks of the beauty blender. You definitely need to set this foundation, otherwise it will slip and slide. It has got medium coverage. Now let me apply makeup on top of it, like concealer and blush and all of that, and see how it performs. I'm gonna fill in my eyebrows guys and I'll be back, just a minute. For my concealer, I'm trying this L'Oreal Infallible. This is in the shade 317 Almond. I'm using this concealer for the first time as well, you guys. Around my mouth as well. Oh, this concealer is amazing. I won't say this foundation is supremely matte, but it is semi matte, as you can tell. Also, this concealer is 10 on 10. I love it. I'm very picky about my concealers. If you have been following me for a while, I think this is the best. So now I'm gonna go and do rest of my makeup and I'll be back and show you guys how it applied. We'll also do the wear test and everything. So now let me do it and get back. So I am done with my makeup and this is how it went. If you want to know my lipstick, I am wearing Miss Claire's lip liner in shade L11, that is brown or something. I will be mentioning it in the description box. And I topped it up with Maybelline's Nude Nuance. Oldie but a goodie, I really love this lipstick since ages, like from 3-4 years. Let's talk about this foundation. Everything went on super smoothly. Nothing is looking bad as I expected. I thought that it's just not going to work. I think I like this one little bit better than Blue Heaven foundation, which is also very affordable. This is also really nice. The only thing is little bit drying around my smile line, like it is settling up. for now let's see how long it can hold up, but otherwise I love the finish. Let's see how it performs also in flash photography. I'll try and take pictures with flash and insert it for you guys to see it, that how it performed, whether it gave flashback or not as well. Currently 2:43, we will wear it for good 6-7 hours. Like I will wear it till 9:30 maybe. 9:30 is max. I don't think I can pull off more than 9:30 for sure. I'll show you guys. So it is looking really really nice. I will say that it is lighter for my skin tone. I wish it has got little bit of warm undertone to it. If it oxidizes, thank God, but if it doesn't, then I don't know. I'm gonna go have my lunch and I'll check back again very very soon. Bye. So it's currently, I don't have my phone near me, but it's 4:54 in the evening. But this is how my foundation is holding up. If I look close, it hasn't oxidized. It hasn't settled into my fine lines. I will try to use this when I'm going out for some occasion and stuff. I have used that L'Oreal concealer. It has not greased as well. So both of the products that I have used for the first time, I'm quite impressed. I was expecting that this foundation might oxidize or settle into my fine lines and things like that, but no, it's holding up quite nicely. I'm very close to the camera so you can see it by yourself. It's actually looking flawless, you guys. That is the update for now. I will check back again around 7:30. Yeah. Hi again. So it's currently 7:13. It's quite a while that I have worn this foundation, almost like four and a half hours. I am super impressed about how nicely it is holding up. It has dried out around my mouth. I'm not gonna lie, very much like I can see it's cracking here. But I think it's the concealer and not the foundation. Nowhere else I can see the cracks or creases or anything. Even it has doesn't form any lines. Yeah, on my forehead it's very very nice. It has settled a little bit around my nose, but very much lesser in comparison to other expensive foundations that I have used. It has smudged a lot under my eyes. Again, I would blame all of it on the concealer and not the foundation, because everywhere else it's just flawless. And with time, I think this foundation is definitely looking better and better. Even my T-zone hasn't gotten oily, not even my chin. Nowhere I can see that there is oiliness or blotchiness. This is my second product from Insight. And first one, I tried their really good lipstick, which was my favorite throughout last year, and still I use the Joyful shade a lot. You can click I up here and see that lipstick swatch video. If I have to talk about their foundation, like after 4 hours of wearing it, I am already impressed. So I think this brand is doing pretty good job with their products. So I have to dig into their collection, that what all they have, and I should be checking out. Please, if you have any suggestions, let me know in the comment section. Now I will check in after 2 hours. Guys, I am with my apron as I was cooking myself a bowl of salad. I can see a lot of the foundation has cracked up around this area. My under eyes is all messed up. All in all, this foundation is pretty good. It is currently 9:45, that is 10 p.m. My phone is on charging. I'm gonna wind up this video with apron itself because my husband is on the way. He'll be knocking at any minute. Let's wind up this video with the pros and cons. First of all, it's very affordable. Let's not forget that. It's easily available online, offline. Insight Cosmetics is made in India brand, so you are definitely supporting our country. And then I love the finish. It is not too matte, it is not too glowy. It's exactly in between. My fan is off, otherwise you won't be able to hear, but this is all the sweat that is coming out because I'm talking very very fast and I have just came out of the kitchen. Even my T-zone is very matte. Guys, I have not even powdered. If you powder it, like, it's going to take you next level, but you don't need to powder. I have just powdered it when I was filming the intro. That's it. I have not powdered after that even once. Longevity is really really good. As you have seen, I'm wearing it from past 6-7 hours, and I think mostly people wear it for max to 10-11 hours, not more than that. I'm very excited to try this foundation during summer. Indian summers are pretty brutal, right? It photographs really well. It didn't give any flashback. It doesn't give you any white cast. Now let's talk about the cons. So first of all is that they have only got 4 shades. Like, that is very sad. It hasn't got the full coverage as it claims to be. It has got medium to full coverage. You definitely have to build it up. Also, the product quantity is really less. You need a lot of product to build it up, get the proper coverage. Also, it's a glass bottle, so you have to be a little careful while traveling. If I have to rate this foundation from 5, I would give 3 and I would cut 2 stars just for the shading. Obviously, everyone want to have affordable foundation in their kit, which is of good quality, but if they don't have more shades, who is going to try, right? Back again, give you guys the last check-in. It's 11:24 and my makeup, it's still on. I have already given an outro, but then I thought of sharing it again. Now I'm finally moving it. I wanted to go out for a little ride, but then we had cancelled. Foundation has quite rubbed off from this area and little bit on my forehead. And also I wanted to add, it is not transfer proof. It will transfer to your clothes and all. And also if you move your finger like that, you will have prints of it, especially on your forehead where it gets little oily. I have not even powdered it once, you guys. I swear on my husband. So it's all how I applied it in the beginning itself. That is the final check out, I would say. This is all about the foundation that I'm done. I have already mentioned the pros and cons and it remains the same. I only wanted to add that wherever you have got oil, give you the imprints of your fingers if you touch your face. So better you carry a compact or something. I don't think that you will get an oily face if you are very, very dry. But yeah, that is it for this foundation. And now finally, bye. Bye.